Welcome to 5 Games 5 Minutes from acornelectron.co.uk. Galactic Patrol is a collection of space-themed sub-games where you have control of a laser sight. On some of the games, you're tasked with shooting alien spacecraft out of the sky. On others, you have to perform operations such as docking or simply avoiding things. The mission in full is to collect some colonists from the planet's surface and deliver them to the Starfleet. The colonists run from left to right, and you have to shoot enough aliens out of the sky that enough colonists survive. However, there's a problem. Often the aliens appear in the bottom part of the screen, right next to the colonists. And inexplicably, if you try to shoot them, no laser appears. And no, that's not because the game is protecting you from shooting the colonists, because the same unfairness happens on the later levels where you have to protect your transporter. Now you do shoot a laser, but in the bottom part of the screen it never hits anything. Galactic Patrol is all quite snoozeworthy, really. Colourful and varied, but ultimately you won't feel like coming back to it. In Jet Boot Jack you play a space-age jogger, who must move quickly through screens of levels collecting musical notes. Above his head hang dangerous stalactites, and between the platforms float transporter hubs. You're not permitted to stand still for longer than 3 seconds, and you must also avoid what the instructions call patrollers and flappers. And wow, what an experience Jet Boot Jack is! By no means an easy one. It's one of those games that seems to continually catch you out. You concentrate so hard on avoiding a patroller that you run slap bang into stalactite, or you hit that transporter just a pixel too early. Playing it is almost to induce nightmarish levels of stress, and yet the game has enough bells and whistles for it not to feel unfair. There's a practice mode, allowing you to learn the layouts of each screen, and when you do complete a screen, you can jump over it the next time you play. Such features are ahead of their time. Difficult but not impossible, Jet Boot Jack all hangs together nicely, and was very highly regarded in its day. LOOPZ is one of those simplistic games that, when it comes along, everyone both starts playing it and thinking, if only I'd thought of that idea. The idea is to use the pieces that you're given to create loops, i.e. an encircled area. When you do this, all the pieces laid to create that loop disappear and you get points. The bigger you make the loop, the more points you get when you lay the final piece. But pieces appear in a random order. So you want to be building numerous loops at the same time, to make sure you don't get stuck needing one particular piece. A furious timer counts down whenever a new piece has to be laid. If you run out of space then, you'll lose a life. Every now and then you're also given a gopher, which will remove an incomplete loop. LOOPZ is quite satisfying, although the Electron version is a bit sluggish when responding to key presses. What you've seen here is just the bare bones too. It has 3 separate games and heaps of different options to keep you playing. Poker invites you to play a hand of poker against a motley crew of suspicious looking characters. And although you wouldn't think playing for computerized money would be very interesting, it's fascinating. In my experience, there's not a lot of skill to poker. You get a random hand, and you might be lucky immediately, or you might want to hang on in the game, hoping to be lucky when you discard up to 3 of your cards. In point of fact, poker the computer game is probably a pretty good experience for many, because you lose about 6 times more often than you win. The real fun of the game isn't in the rules per se, but in the narratives that you're given as each hand progresses. When it says, John Smith scowls evilly, it really gets your imagination going. The serving wench also gives you handy advice, if you ask her. All the controls are self-explanatory, and the game is zippy enough that the action doesn't drag. A really good game, all in all. I've played Dynabyte's version of Pool, in order to give it a fair hearing, and in so doing I have spared you from the misery of attempting it. Pool goes wrong from the start. It's 2-player only, and it's consecutive turn-based like a real game. Fair enough, but the control keys are then different for each player. That might make sense in a dogfight style game, but it doesn't work here. It's also difficult to aim the cue, which appears as a very slowly moving line. When you do take the shot, the ball only vaguely follows the path you've set. If balls ricochet, it's patently not how they would behave in real life. Potting even a single ball takes hours, never mind trying to pot a succession of them. Probably in 1983, Dynabyte could just about get away with this rubbish, and it'll send anyone interested in pool back to the real thing in 2 minutes flat.